Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying structure respiration. In that we are studying topic significance of ATP. When I say significance of ATP, it means importance of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Let's find out how it is important for plants as well as animals. When I say ATP, it means adenosine triphosphate, the energy currency of cell, the energy molecule of cell. Oxidative phosphorylation is a process by which an inorganic phosphate is added to ADP to form your ATP molecule. And this process takes place in various cycles, whether you are studying photophosphorylation, photosystems, glycolysis, Krebs cycle, everywhere this process takes place. In a cell, if any metabolic or anabolic process is going on, at that time, ATP is needed. Now, ATP is the energy currency of the cell. It is the ATP that is broken down and used as an energy source for the cell to carry out the process. So, if I say that whatever you as human beings are going to eat will be converted in ATP, yes, it will be. If I say that plants, whenever they do photosynthesis and prepare their food glucose, the final destination to reach is ATP or the energy currency, yes, it is. So, ATP basically to every individual which is living on earth is like money. And body treats it very seriously and takes its uses very specifically. If there is no use for energy to invest, the process is not required, body is not going to waste its ATP, whether it is plant body or whether it is animal body. Significance of ATP, or you can say the importance of ATP. When I say ATP, it means adenosine triphosphate. Now, the process of oxidative phosphorylation, that is process used for the synthesis of ATP production. Now, what happens is that an inorganic phosphate molecule is added up to ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate, which is 2-phosphate, to form your ATP, which is adenosine triphosphate. And for this, various biological resources are used from a cell, whether it's plant or animal cell. Now, ATP is a store for biologically usable form of energy. Whenever there's a requirement from energy from ATP, what is done is the phosphate bond of ATP is broken down or shunned down, and you gain energy from that ATP molecule. Now basically ATP provides energy for the synthesis of carbohydrates, which is glucose, from CO2 during the process of photosynthesis. We all know that the process of photosynthesis uses CO2, that is from atmosphere, and plus water in the presence of chlorophyll in the leaf, and form glucose molecule, which is a form of carbohydrate and the plant food. ATP is converted in any state, whether it is plants or animal, into ADP plus IP, which is inorganic phosphate, that is usually usable form of energy. So you basically have ATP, ADP, and then AMP. When I say ATP, it is adenosine triphosphate, ADP is adenosine diphosphate, and AMP is adenosine monophosphate. In simple life, if I have to sum up, I could say that ATP is the main source of energy for all metabolic reactions in a cell. It's the energy currency of the cell, and large amount of ATP is formed inside mitochondria. Students, this is a diagram of one ATP molecule. One ATP molecule basically consists of three phosphate groups which are broken down and released energy. One adenine group, remember the nitrogen bases, one is the adenine group, and a ribose sugar, or you can say a pentose sugar, which is a 5-carbon sugar. These three different molecules constitute to make one ATP molecule. Now ribose sugar in this is the RNA form of sugar, which consists of OH group. Adenine is one of the nucleotides which is present even in DNA, and phosphate group, this is the high energy giving group in ATP. Students, I hope you all are very, very clear about what is the significance of ATP and how does ATP looks like and it works about. Thank you.